Hi there, I'm Peter Upvold, and in this video tutorial I'm going to show you how you can install the latest version of PHP, that's 5.5 at the time of recording, on CentOS 6. So I've been running a Moodle install on CentOS 6 for some time, and I've been keeping it up to date with the latest version of Moodle as soon as it comes out. I ran into a problem recently when Moodle 2.7 was released. We can see here these are the system requirements for Moodle 2.7, and it's now requiring PHP 5.4.4. which is entirely reasonable. PHP 5.4 has been around for a very long time now. However, CentOS 6, being stable and hanging back on many new packages, only ships 5.3.3. They backport security updates, but we don't get the new features, which means we can't run Moodle 2.7 on CentOS 6 without addressing that problem. There's also actually a problem with the version of MySQL, but we'll look at that maybe in another video. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I solve this problem to install PHP 5.5 on CentOS 6, and it remains nice and stable. We've not modified too many packages, we've not taken in a load of third-party stuff, we're just really focused on getting PHP on here. So let me show you how I've done this, and I'm going to briefly show you what we're using. This project here, the IUS community project, the whole goal of this project is to provide up-to-date PHP packages specifically for Red Hat Enterprise Linux, and of course compatible distributions like CentOS. So it's fantastic. It's done by the people at Rackspace. Now there are some other repositories you can find that do similar things, but they're often just random GitHub repositories. You're not really sure who's behind them. What I like about this project is you have got that backing of a company that is actually using this in production. They've got a vested interest in making sure it's secure and stable and doesn't mess up any of the rest of the configuration of your CentOS or Red Hat system. So that's why I like this. So let's get started. Now the first thing we need to do is actually install the extra packages for Enterprise Linux, or EPEL, repository on CentOS, because the IUS repository actually depends upon a few things in EPEL. So we're going to grab this. I found this tutorial here just because it gives me the URL to the repository. So I'm just going to copy that. And I'm going to go across to my server, and we're going to go ahead and install that. As you can see, I've just been installing Moodle a moment ago. So we're going to do rpm-ivh and just paste in that URL there. And that's going to go ahead and download and install EPEL. Now that's done, I'm just going to run yum update quickly to allow it to cache the repository and just get everything ready before we go ahead and add more. And there we go. It's not found anything to update, but that's fine. We've just given it a bit of a... we've just primed that repository so it's ready to go. So we need to go ahead and grab the repository. So we'll go to repos, and then we'll find CentOS 6, and I'm on 64-bit, so I want this one. And I don't want that, though. I probably want the release package, don't I? So we'll go ahead all the way down. The EPEL release, what we've already installed, and the IUS release as well. So here's the RPM that we need to install to get that repository loaded. We'll copy that. And again, I'll head back across to the server and we'll do the same thing, rpm-ivh, and paste that in. Okay, so we'll just do the same thing again. We'll run yum update to allow that repository to be loaded in. Okay, so we're ready to go. Now, we need to take a moment just to get a list of the PHP packages we're running. The way we're going to do this is we're going to do it as a single yum transaction. So we're going to remove all of the old packages that are PHP packages, then reinstall the new PHP 5.5 packages, but in one transaction, so there's never a point that those PHP packages aren't actually installed on the system, so you're not going to end up trying to remove everything that depends upon PHP as well, which will be a bit of a nightmare. So we remove the old packages and then add the new packages in one transaction. It works quite well. So in order to do that, we need to list the PHP packages we're using so that we know what we're using. So we'll do rpm-qa, which lists all packages, and then we're going to pipe that to grep php, which is going to search for the word php in that output. And this should give us a list of all of the PHP packages that we're using. Okay, so to do this transaction, we're going to go into the yum shell. Normally, if we're doing yum, we'll just issue a command on one line, like yum install something. But we're going to do a load of commands at once in this transaction. So we're going to go into yum shell. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is we need to remove each one of these packages. So I'm going to type remove and then just list those packages, just reading them off there. Soap, PHP MV string, common, PHP GD, PHP CLI, PHP itself, PHP MySQL, PHP XML, and PHP XML RPC. Just make sure you've spelt those correctly, because if you get it wrong, you have to type the whole command again, which is a bit annoying. So, we press enter, it's going to set up that remove process, but it hasn't actually done it yet. We've just prepared it. Until we tell the transaction to run, nothing's going to happen. Now we do the same thing. We take this list of packages, but we install the PHP 5.5u, which is the prefix for the Unicode version of PHP 5.5, and then just reinstall all those packages again. So we'll do install PHP 5.5u-ldap, PHP 5.5u-pdo, and so on. String common five u for just PHP normally with no suffix. U-MySQL. Oh, looks like I've gone off the end of the line there. There we go. PHP 5.5u-XML. PHP 5.5u-XML RPC. And it's very important that you also add PHP 5.5u-JSON, because that is now a separate package, although it was included in the 5.3 distribution. So make sure you add this package if you don't, even if you don't have it in this list here. So if I've typed everything correctly, I'll press enter. It's going to take a little bit of a moment just to get ready here, so we need to be slightly patient. Okay, and again, it's set up the install process, but not run it yet. Now we need to run transaction solve, and this is going to check that the dependencies are all resolved and there isn't going to be a problem actually running this transaction in a minute. And it's succeeded at that, so that's good. We can now just run transaction run. And what that's going to do, it's going to give us a list of the things it's going to download. It's going to show us, if we scroll up, it's installing these and removing these at the same time, and installing a couple of things it needs there for dependencies. So we'll let that install. This is the first time we've installed from the IUS repository, so we should go ahead and check that GPG key somehow. I'm just going to accept it here. That GPG key obviously makes sure that these packages really are from IUS and aren't imposter packages. Okay, we are getting a few errors here, but I imagine that might just be because the install is still going on. Right, so it's finished the transaction. We can now exit out of yum, and that's actually done now. So for good measure, I'm going to restart my web server here to make sure it picks up the new PHP install. Okay, and we'll head back on over to our server. I've actually got a normal PHP info page that I've put in, and we can just see what version of PHP we're running. And there we go, PHP 5.5.12. So now if we head back to the environment page for Moodle, not the quickest of web applications when you don't have caching on. There we go, we've got PHP, where's it gone? PHP here, 5.4 is required and you're running 5.5.12. And obviously now that we are tracking that repository, as new versions of PHP 5.5 and maybe even 5.6 come out, well, the 5.5 updates you'll get as normal YUM updates, 5.6 will be a separate set of packages, probably with a new PHP 5.6 prefix of some kind when that is available. So there we go, we've installed PHP 5.5 and we can now use any applications that require those features. Now, we still can't get a Moodle 2.7 here because we also need an updated version of MySQL. But I'm actually going to look at in another video how you can replace Oracle MySQL with MariaDB and solve that problem too. So I hope this was helpful. I hope this lets you get PHP 5.5 on your CentOS 6 system. Thank you for watching and goodbye.